Hi, my name is Dr Shahid Bashir. In this video, I will tell you how to conduct the discussion and conclusion of your entire study. So, by continuing with our previous examples, this is where we end in the last video by summarizing the findings. So, this was the research purpose to examine the mediating function of consumer trust in web vendors and the relationship among the components of online perceived risk and online purchase intention, and it was split into several research questions, and attending those research questions did answered the results to attaining the objectives, and then the hypothesis and findings. So all of them were in line, and these were the findings. So in this particular section, what we need to do is to discuss all these results in comparison or in line with the previous studies that are discussed in the literature review. So other than this, there are other subsections also, so which I will discuss later on, but first I will read this statement. There is the introduction to this chapter. While fourth chapter ended in testing the hypothesis of the study, this chapter discusses these results along with presenting an overall conclusion. Okay, discussion and conclusion. For the convenience of readers, this chapter is presented in five sections. Okay, these five sections comprise the entire chapter. The first section discusses and justifies the study findings. The remaining sections conclude the entire study along with presenting implication, limitation, and suggestions. So five things: discussion, conclusion, implication, limitation, and suggestion. So okay, discussion of the results. So now, as I said earlier, so in this section, the results of your hypothesis will be compared to some of the previous studies that are discussed in the literature review. So either it would be in line or comparative to the previous results. So in the similar context, I must say there. Okay, the findings of this study point toward a set of replications for the scholars, while past studies blah 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 often considered perceived risk as a one-dimensional construct. The researchers' analysis of the cause and effect relationship between perceived risk and purchase intention was conducted by separating the risk into four dimensions: performance, financial, psychological, time. Consequently, this study focused on presenting perceived risk as a multi-dimensional construct that tends to increase online consumer trust and purchase intention. So just a little introduction. So what is special about this particular study? So we had unmediated model assessment. So now what we see here regarding the unmediated influence of perceived risk, two out of four hypotheses were supported. So these two hypotheses were okay. The results were similar to numerous existing studies. Okay, these were there in the literature review. Okay, now one thing is, so if for example your studies are other way around than any other previous study, so you must justify why the results are not in line with the previous study. So for example, in addition, the results were somewhat supported by one Malaysian study as well. However, in comparison to existing related study, the overall outcome of this study were slightly inconsistent and weak. So now why? There are several reasons. Okay, you can just stop this video and just read all these things. So then, okay, some of them which are unproven, means the rejected hypothesis, there is a reason, proper reason behind this also. So all those reasons are discussed and compared with the previous studies.